Hey everyone, how are you? Hope you're really well. Hope you've all had the best week. Welcome back to my kitchen. Today, we're gonna make a dish that I grew up absolutely loving. I grew up on the island of Gallimnos, back and forth to Adelaide, Australia. But something that we absolutely love is fish. And today I'm gonna show you a way of making Psari Plaki. Now, to start this magnificent dish, we're gonna do it with some fillets. And the first thing we're gonna do is set up a beautiful mouth-watering, yet very simple salsa. So come over to the cooktop and let's set it up. Okay, here we are, it's salsa time, all right? Remember, for this recipe, get onto the Meraki TV website, have a look. It's got everything in detail, very basic. Let's do it. In our cacerola here, with a little bit of ladaki. Nothing wrong with a bit of good olive oil. And we get our cremidaki, a little bit of scordo. Now at this point, what I do is I sit there and I saute this so that it lightly browns. So you've got to be pretty patient. Let it go for a good 5 or 10 minutes. And you just keep stirring it. In the meantime, you can have your karasaki, sit back, relax. While you're doing this, talking, solving the world's problems, you know. If you saute these properly so they start to become translucent, like see-through, or just lightly brown them, that's gonna bring the sugars out and that's gonna give your salsa that extra edge. It's now browned up beautifully, ready to go. The smell is amazing. Okay, now we're gonna add the tomato paste. Stir that in so that we can cook it out. Then we start adding our tomato salsas. I'll let that heat up. And now, because I'm a good Greek boy and I was taught by my mother, I'm gonna put a little bit of neraki in here and rinse it out so that we don't waste any domata. That's it, my mother would be proud. Now we add our alataki. A little bit of piperi. Now we put 3/4 of that chopped parsley. You can use different herbs, but I like to use parsley because it's not overpowering. It's got that beautiful freshness and something that a lot of us have been brought up with as far as flavors go. So I use about probably 3/4 of that half bunch. Stir it in. This is smelling very good. Okay, the salsa's ready. El latte sto bago. Our baking tray. The oven is now preheated at 180 degrees, so it's ready to go. I've got my psaraka here. I'm gonna start off by putting a couple of kutalies, so a couple of ladle loads of salsa in the bottom. And then we have our fish fillets, which we place. And then we spread the rest of that salsa over the top. Now, this here is the healthy version where we're gonna do it just psari with a magnificent salsa. We're gonna put it in the oven and cook it. It's gonna come out beautifully baked. You can also, if you wanted to, get some patates, and because the patates aren't gonna quite, they're gonna take a little bit longer than the fish. The fish isn't gonna take quite as long to cook. You can pre-bake a few patates and have them semi, you know, probably 3/4 ready. And then you can add them in amongst this dish as well. So you can enjoy them with the psari as well. I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of that parsley over the top now. And then I'll leave a little bit and sprinkle it over as soon as it comes out of the oven. I'll sprinkle a little bit of fresh on top of it as well. And it's ready to go. So in the furno, and we're nearly there. Ah, there we have it, psari plaki. Just like your yaya used to make, do it, enjoy. No words required. Get that little bit of parsley now, sprinkle it freshly over the top, just to freshen it up, then plate it up, eat it with the salata or psomaki, as we said a bit earlier. You will not regret. Go for it.